Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk more about how to manipulate strings using string operations and methods. The first type of string operation I will introduce is concatenation. We define two strings, S1 and S2. They contain hello and world, respectively. A plus sign is used for string concatenation. It joins two strings end to end. Now I define two more strings. One is comma space. It just contains a comma and a space. The other one is exclamation, which just contains an exclamation. This statement will assemble these strings together in proper order. As a result, we see hello, comma, space, world, exclamation, which is a short but complete sentence. A star is used for string repetition. It will repeat a string multiple times. In this example, 2 times S1 means we will repeat hello twice. This statement means we will repeat hello twice, we will repeat world 3 times, and then we join them together. We can use a function len to get the length of a string. S1 is hello, which has 5 characters, so its length is 5. This for loop will go through every character in S1 and print out the character. By default, each character is printed in one line, so the word hello is printed vertically. We can change this by specifying a second parameter, end equals an empty string. Now the word hello is printed horizontally. If we change this empty string to a space, then the word hello will be printed horizontally and separated by space. The keyword in will check whether a string is contained in another string. This statement checks whether AP is a substring of apple. It is, so the answer is true. This statement will check whether the letter I is a substring of apple. It's not, so the answer is false. The following program will create a username using a person's first name and the first 7 characters of the last name. We define a function main because we want to run this program over and over to create usernames for different people. In the body of the main function, we first ask the user to give us their first name, store that information in the variable first name. Then we ask the user to give us their last name, store that information in the variable last name. Next, we use string indexing to access the first character of their first name. Because Python indexing starts from 0, this is the first name, brackets, 0. Then we use string slicing to access the first 7 characters of the last name. The start is not defined, so it starts from 0, goes up to 7, but not including 7. That means we get the letters in positions 0 through 6, which is a total of 7 characters. Finally, we print out the username. Let's call this main function. What's your first name? Let's give it a very famous name, Taylor. What's your last name? Swift. The username is tswift. This last name is fairly short. We don't even have 7 characters, but the function can still generate a correct username using only what is available. Let's try it again. This time with a different name, Arnold Schwarzenegger. The username is A. Schwartz. The program works correctly. Mutability is a very important concept in Python. Strings are immutable. That means we cannot change its content individually. This is very different from another data type called list, which will be discussed in another video. For example, S1 is hello. If we try to change the first character from letter E to letter A like this, we will see an error. It says string object does not support item assignment. If you really want to change that character, you must change the variable as a whole, like this. We can manipulate strings using the following method. Note that these methods are not done in place. That means they just return the new manipulated results, but they do not make changes to the original string. The original string S contains two sentences. Don't give up on your dreams, keep sleeping. This is a funny quote I found on the internet. S.capitalize is a method that will capitalize only the first character in the string. There is no parameter inside the parentheses. As a result, D is still capitalized and K is changed to a lowercase. The title method will capitalize the first letter of every word in the string. This is the result. The lower method will change the string to lowercase. The upper method does the opposite, changes every character to its uppercase. The replace method in this statement will find the word don't and replace it with do. Note that these words are both case sensitive. The result is do give up on your dreams, keep sleeping. L-just means left justified. The parameter 50 means it will take the space of 50 characters to show the result. Center means the string is centered. R-just means right justified. If the parameter in the center method is less than the actual length of the string, this parameter will be ignored. It will just show the entire original string. Count all will count how many letter O's the string contains. We have one O, two O's, and three O's. Find O will return the index of the first letter O in the string from the left. The index is 1. Rfind O will return the index of the last letter O in the string. That means we are searching from the right. The index is 18. Let's define a list named PFE. It contains three strings, Python for engineers. Now we use the join method to join the strings in this list PFE together. They are separated by space, which is defined in front of the dot join method. You can use any separator you want. The isDigit method will check if the string contains all digit characters 0 through 9. 64? Yes. They are both digits. 6? No, the characters are not digits. Lstrip removes the leading spaces in a string. Like this one, the leading spaces are all removed. It does nothing to the spaces at the end or the spaces in the middle. Strip removes both leading and following spaces. R space removes only the following spaces. This statement will check if engineers starts with ENG. The answer is true. This statement will check if engineers start with all lowercase ENG. The answer is false. That means it's case sensitive. Okay, I just talked about string operations and methods in this video. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.